previously on Harmony and Chaos. It was a trek 7 years into the past as Shadow and Starlight tracked Aeon through time. It didn't take Aeon long to track down and reunite with the sunset shimmer of that time. Aeon's convincing story of his past with Sunset allowed the past version of her to agree to an alliance with him. Elsewhere in the past timeline, Shadow and Starlight had learned of Will Atkinson's whereabouts and hurried off to Vancouver to warn him before Aeon could absorb his powers, thus completing the Triad of Power and Aeon's ascension to the God of Power. Upon arriving at the theater, Shadow would accidentally put the past timeline in jeopardy by meeting and sharing future information with the Twilight Sparkle of the past. Meanwhile, in present-day Equestria, Chaotix began adapting to life in Equestria and reunited with some old friends. While Nightshade officially agreed to temporary rule over Europony as Prince William decided to exile back in Ponyville. However, back in the past, much to the dismay of Starlight, Shadow had offered a date to past Twilight, a date in which Starlight worried could put the natural flow of the past timeline in jeopardy. Did Twilight and Shadow's date go too far? And if they did, what will the effects be on the past's timeline? And will Aeon be successful in obtaining the complete Triad of Power? Find out in this gripping episode of Harmony and Chaos. Episode 93, Showdown in the Past.
Seven years in the past, Twilight's hotel room. Twilight releases Shadow from her magic.
What's wrong, Twilight? Please, don't cry.
They sit at the edge of the bed together.
I am so sorry, Shadow. I had no right doing what I just did. Could you please forgive me?
Shadow wipes away her tears.
There's nothing to forgive you for. I'm the one who should be apologizing. I'm the one who started flirting with you. I played with your emotions, though unintentional, it was still wrong. It's just when I saw you, I immediately saw my Twilight, and I couldn't help but feel something.
That's one of the reasons why time travel is forbidden. It's just I'm not used to getting any attention, let alone romantic attention. And the way you look at me, the way you treat me, I truly know that in your time dimension, I'm your princess. The hard part is, I don't want you to go back, but I know that's inevitable, isn't it?
Yes, but Twilight, if history is the same here, then you and I will meet eventually.
But what if it isn't the same, Shadow? What then? What if in this timeline Mobius is spared and we don't meet?
That's a hard fact, but we both know that scenario is possible as well.
Spike begins waking up.
Twilight, is everything all right? Who is this guy?
Yeah, no worries, Spike. Everything is all right. This is an old friend of mine who I haven't seen in a while. We ran into each other today, and he's the friend who I was having dinner with.
Shadow extends his hand.
The name is Shadow. It's a pleasure to finally meet you, Spike.
Likewise. What exactly are you?
I'm a Mobian Hedgehog, and I come from a different dimension altogether.
And how do you know Twilight? She's never mentioned you before.
Shadow and I were childhood friends. From before you hatched. That's why you've never met him before, Spike.
Yes, and I do a lot of traveling and whatnot. I can assure you, Spike, Twilight matters a great deal to me. So I mean her no harm.
Well, that's good, because that was my main concern when I heard Twilight crying.
I suppose I should probably head out for tonight anyway. It's getting late, and you should be getting some rest.
No. Please, stay the night. I promise, no more funny business on my part. You've had a bit too much wine tonight, and I'm worried about you making it back to your hotel room safely.
Trust me. I'll be fine, Twilight. I promise. I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
Twilight blushes and gives Shadow a cute, faint smile.
Okay. And again, my apologies for being so abrasive tonight.
It's water under the bridge. Mwah. Good night, Twilight.
Twilight walks Shadow out.
Wait, you do still want to be my date for Saturday night, right?
Of course. I wouldn't dream of ever standing you up. I'll see you in the morning. Sleep tight, Twilight.
Mwah. Shadow gently kisses Twilight's cheek. Twilight re-enters her hotel room and closes the door.
What is so funny, Spike? You two totally have a crush on each other. Will you stop? It's more complicated than that, Spike.
Ugh, why does everything have to be complicated with you adults? If you like the guy and he likes you, I don't see what's so complicated about it.
I will say this, though. Shadow does make me excited about the future.
I can't do this alone, even though I am strong. Need something more than me, someone to push me to victory. Let's see what we can do, together me and you. Can't be afraid to try, kiss your fears goodbye. No looking back, you and I were on the attack. Full speed ahead, running to the sunset. Such a different feeling, both of us believing. We can make it better. Together we can show the world what we can do.
Honestly, it was manic. I wouldn't be lying if I said it was probably the best of my life.
Yeah. Not the first time I heard that one.
I bet you broke a lot of girls' hearts over the years.
If you were to place that bet, you'd be a very wealthy girl. I've broken a lot of girls' hearts, but Pinkie Pie was the one girl who stole mine. Honestly, I think karma played a role in our breakup. I guess I have changed a bit, though. Because the younger me wouldn't even be in this room with you right now.
Well, you may not want to hear this, kid, but deep down you're an incredible guy, Manic. You're such a passionate lover and sweet, too.
Yeah. You know, for a one-night stand, things did get pretty intense between this last night. We had an instant connection. You're easy to talk to.
That was an awesome night for sure. I'm kind of, like, hoping maybe we can make this a thing. You know, just without the relationship part.
I was thinking the same thing. In fact, I was kinda hoping you maybe want to go with me back to Ponyville and attend my band's album. release party is my date. And it's totally a red carpet event.
Like, oh my gosh! I've always wanted to attend one of those.
Then consider this your lucky day. I seriously had a great time with you last night. It would be an honor having you there as a hot distraction. What do you say, kid? You want to party like a rock star?
Like, yeah. I would love to attend as your hot, distractive date. Do I need to dress up for it?
Nah. Something similar to what you had on last night should be fine. We're going to have to hop on the train here pretty soon, though. I got to make it back tonight for our final rehearsal at the studio.
That's cool. All I have to do is feed my kitty, pack a light bag, and take a quick shower before we go. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's cool. And thanks for wanting to tag along with me.
Well, thanks for asking me.
Meanwhile, Ponyville. Spike walking Sweetie Belle to school.
Thanks for walking me to school, Spike. It's a sweet gesture and I'm enjoying spending the time with you.
Yeah, I felt pretty bad lately about spending time with Cream. There was just so much unresolved feelings that we both had to address, but I can honestly say that I know where my feelings lie and who my heart belongs to. I'm sorry if I've been distant, but...
You don't have to apologize. I know how much Cream means to you, and given the nature in which she was taken from you, it's understandable that there would be some unresolved feelings with her return. I'd be more worried if there wasn't, honestly, but I am happy you've been honest with me about everything.
Again, thanks for being patient. Both Cream and I needed this closure, and she needed me to let her go.
To allow you to have your time and space with her. In the end, I figure you wouldn't appreciate me butting in, knowing Cream's time here is limited and temporary. I knew you'd come to me when you were ready. So, are you going to the DJ Pond 3 band's first album release party tomorrow night?
Yeah, I'm going with Twilight. What about you?
Yeah, I'm coming with Rarity and Capper.
How are things going between you and Rarity? Have you forgiven her yet?
Fully, but this is typical of Rarity and I. We always find a reason to have a feud, then make up in the end. I never understood why we do fight so much, considering the large age gap between us.
Yeah, Rarity will always be Rarity. I look back at it now, and I was a fool to think I could ever have been in love with her.
She always took you for granted, Spike. I remember seeing you flirt with Rarity all the while. I kept thinking to myself, I wish Spike would notice me. Yeah. I've had a crush on you for the longest time.
You know what's funny, though? I did notice you in those days. There were seriously a couple of instances where I thought about asking you out on a date, but I figured it would be weird or that you were too young to date.
Well, in those days, yes, definitely. Too young for what we have now. But we are nearing our teenage years, Spike. And lately, I've been having some thoughts about... Yeah, no.
Sweet Celestia, really? With me?
Of course, silly. Why are you so surprised? I mean, Rarity had already experienced it at our age, and you've experienced it with Cream. So, what's the big deal?
It is a big deal, though. I can't speak on Rarity's experiences, but I've only experienced it a few times with Cream, and it just kind of happened. We never planned it or anything. It was the connection we shared that led that stuff to happen.
Are you saying that you're not there feelings-wise?
No, it's not like that at all. In fact, I am there. It's just, I don't want to feel pressured or feel like I'm pressuring you into it. Like I said, with Cream it happened a couple of times randomly while we were alone at the castle. But make no mistake, the intense emotional feelings that were involved made it impossible to stop.
I get what you're saying. You think I'm trying too hard by talking about it, huh?
Not at all, but from what I've experienced, words aren't necessary for it to happen. I think that's where I am with you. I love you that much, I know for certain. But we've never really had the chance to get to that level of romance before, you know?
Yeah, you're right. We haven't. I'm not saying that I want to yet, but I wanted you to know I have been thinking about it. I'm sorry if this is making you uncomfortable. I'm embarrassed for talking about it myself.
Well, don't be embarrassed. It's like you said, we are nearing our teenage years, so this is completely normal. Trust me, sweetie, it's going to happen one of these days, and when it does, it won't take a discussion for it to happen.
I'm glad we talked about this, Spike. I love you.
I love you too. They continue walking towards Ponyville Elementary. Meanwhile, 7 years in the past. Vancouver. Shadow and Starlight's hotel room. Shadow waking up.
Long night last night, huh?
Starlight, what time is it?
It's just after 11. I was up half the night worried sick about you. I take it your date with Twilight went well?
We had a good time.
You slept with her, didn't you, Shadow?
Oh, of course not. Not that it's any of your business, Starlight. You really think I'm that stupid?
Well, considering how you've acted towards her, yes, I really think you are that stupid. Do you even realize the severity of how your actions with her could have drastically altered the natural flow of this timeline?
Yes, and Aeon coming here hasn't altered a damn thing. Nothing I told Twilight is going to change her future. She'll still accomplish everything she's destined to accomplish.
Why were you out so late? It was after 2 a.m. before I finally gave up waiting on you and went to bed.
After I left Twilight's hotel room, I stayed out and went for a walk to clear my head. I won't deny that something did almost happen between me and Twilight last night. Starlight face hooves.
What exactly happened, Shadow?
Went out for dinner and talked like I originally had intended. I told her the important things she needed to know about how we know each other. Didn't give her direct details about how things happened. I was careful. I also told her about Aeon and how she befriended Sunset in our timeline. I had to tell her the truth.
Yes, I get that we had to tell Twilight the truth. I wish we could have avoided meeting her, but go on. I can't wait to hear the rest of this story.
We had a little bit too much wine during dinner. We naturally started joking around, making small talk, and flirting.
I knew wine was involved! I know from my own experiences with you that you become a complete simp when you've had too much to drink!
After dinner, we walked around town for a bit before I walked her back to her hotel room. She asked me to be her date for tomorrow night's show at the theater, which I figured we were going to be there anyway, so I said yes. Twilight thanked me for a wonderful evening, and that's when things got a little steamy. He started kissing me, and I couldn't help but give in and kiss her back. Starlight shaking her head. What? Why are you shaking your head at me?
Somehow, I'm having a hard time believing it was Twilight who initiated the kiss. You do remember what happened the day you met Twilight in our timeline, right?
What does that have to do with anything?
You and I were together when you met Twilight, and what's more, you wanted me to attack her over Rouge's Chaos Emerald. You've given this timeline's version of Twilight a preconceived notion about who you are. Do you realize how drastically you could have changed that moment alone for this timeline?
I told this timeline's Twilight about what happened the day she met me.
I thought you didn't give her any details, Shadow!
Oh, what the hell was I supposed to do, Starlight? We show up here from the future, claiming that we're trying to stop Aeon. He didn't want to meet Twilight, but it happened, and we had to divulge some information to get Will and Twilight to cooperate with us.
I understand that, Shadow, but you've completely crossed the line with the Twilight of this dimension. She's already in love with you, and she wasn't even supposed to meet you for another 6 years!
Fine! Let's just wait for Aeon to make his move, and take him down so we can get the hell out of this dimension, and back to our own, before we do any more damage.
For once, we agree on something. Now that you're awake, we need to get over to the theater and watch over Will's rehearsal.
Shadow and Starlight leave their hotel room. Day would quickly give way to night. The final rehearsal was taken incredibly seriously, as this was the cast's last chance to iron out all of the details before the first curtain would rise the following evening. Day could not have gone more awkwardly perfect, as there was no sign of Aeon. Avoiding Twilight like a plague, barely said two words to her during the entire day of rehearsals.
Wow, I've been impressed by your resolve today. You haven't even made an effort to talk to Twilight today.
I know I haven't. It's easily the most difficult thing I've ever had to do.
I know it's for the best. Here to take down Aeon, and that's what I need to be focusing on.
I'm glad to hear it. Well, all in all, I'd say this day was a success. No Aeon, no Twilight simping, and no jeopardy to this timeline's history.
Yeah, great. Now let's go before all that changes.
Shadow and Starlight begin to make their way towards the exit in the back of the theater. Ul stops them just before they make their exit. Hey, you two. I know each other, but I want to show my appreciation for you guys protecting me.
You're welcome, and really, there's no need for any extravagant gratitude.
Oh, I insist. It's a tradition of mine to have a massive cast and crew feast the final night of rehearsals. I ordered catering, and I'm cordially inviting the two of you to stay for the party.
This is very nice of you, Will, but...
Shadow, please wait!
As Twilight and Spike rush over to catch up with Shadow and Starlight, Starlight lets out a disappointed sigh.
Well, sure, I guess we'll stay for the party. Thank you for inviting us, Will.
Don't mention it, it's the least I could do for you guys, and it would be rude of me not to ask. Anyway, help yourself to the food and enjoy.
Hello, Twilight. Spike.
Starlight gives Shadow an approving nod.
I know you've been trying to avoid me today, and I'm sincerely sorry for what I attempted to do last night. I would understand if you didn't want to be my date for tomorrow night's opening performance.
Go ahead and talk to her, Shadow. I'm gonna go up to grab some food. Do you want anything?
No, thank you. I'll go up and grab something later.
Spike? Oh, all right, I'll leave you two alone. Spike walks away as well.
My apologies for being distant today. I was indeed trying to avoid you, but somehow I knew that would be impossible.
Can't blame you for feeling that way. I shouldn't have done what I did last night. And again, I'm deeply sorry for it. Promise, it won't happen again.
Twilight, it's my fault why things got out of control last night. I've told you things about the future I shouldn't have. I've shared feelings with you that I should be sharing with only with my Twilight. And by doing so, I put the natural flow of this timeline in jeopardy. That's why I've been avoiding you today.
I didn't want to continue altering time, and there's also the issue of playing with your emotions. You may not be my Twilight, but I still care deeply about you, and I don't want to hurt you by giving you false feelings.
We can't change that now. It's already too late for that. I know you said in your timeline you treated me horribly when we first met, but I can't pretend like I haven't seen the wonderful side of you.
That's the whole point, Twilight. You weren't supposed to see this side of me. Damn it, we weren't even supposed to meet for another 6 years. Now you're going to have this preconceived notion that we're destined to be lovers, and it's going to change the way you treat the Shadow of this time when you do meet him. I didn't intend for us to meet, Twilight, and this is the reason why. I love you, and it doesn't matter which version of you was before me. I can't help but want to love you, to protect you. But it is wrong. I was wrong for not rationalizing the situation. All I saw was you, Twilight. And to me, that's the only thing that matters. I could not rationally separate you from my Twilight.
It's going to be all right, Shadow. I know what to expect when you do arrive here. And I promise I'm not going to do anything that will jeopardize the future here.
You think it's so easy to just sweep your emotions under the rug? I couldn't even control myself when we met yesterday. I know you have feelings for me. It won't be so easy to control yourself when you meet the Shadow of this time. There's a chance he'll kill you if you show any love towards him at all. Because I know what I wanted Starlight to do to you when I met you for the first time back in my dimension.
But you didn't, though.
Yes, that's because I had Starlight there to talk me out of it. By you meeting me now, it may have put that whole moment of your history in jeopardy. It's from that moment that you and I very slowly started to develop feelings for one another. The Twilight of my time didn't have any feelings towards me when we met, but you do, and if you're not careful, it could have a drastic effect in your timeline. Like I told you, our natural love saved Equestria and each other from evil spells twice. I'm just afraid that that won't happen now because of our meeting.
Well, there's also the chance that things won't happen the same in this dimension. What if our two timelines have different realities? My point is, stop being so hard on yourself and thinking you've doomed our timeline and my future. There's even a chance I may not become a princess in this time. With Aeon on the loose, who knows what's going to happen? All that matters to me now is that you're here, and I have enjoyed the time that we've shared together. And I say that as a friend. I'm truly grateful to have met you, Shadow, and I have no regrets at all, and neither should you.
Shadow gives past Twilight a smile. Meanwhile, Starlight is sitting alone eating her food when Past Will decides to approach her. Hey there, enjoying the food?
Yeah, it was very thoughtful of you to invite Shadow and I to your party.
Well, I saw that you guys are trying to cut out of here pretty quickly, and I can't help but notice the intensity between Twilight and your friend Shadow.
Those two have quite an intense relationship between them in the timeline we come.
And as far as you as I go?
I beg your pardon?
Can't hide it from me, Starlight. I am still an Alicorn and all, and I get this feeling that there's more to you than what you've been leading on.
Whatever is giving you this idea, I barely know you in the timeline in which we come.
I've seen you looking at me, and when we met yesterday, you said something to Shadow that stuck in my mind. Told him not to tell us about the history between the four of us, since it doesn't matter to Twilight and I.
Even if there's a story to tell, Will, I won't be sharing any of it with you. It's bad enough that both you and Twilight know as much as you do.
I get why you shouldn't tell me, but Starlight, I get this feeling when I'm around you that indicates to me that we're more than just friends or acquaintances.
Even if I told you anything, it won't change anything between you and I. We can't share what I share with you in my time.
Aha! I knew there was something more going on here between us.
There is nothing going on between us. My relationship is with the you in my time. Unlike Shadow, I can differentiate between the two versions of you. Although, I will admit, it's nice seeing this version of you again.
What do you mean by that? Aswell takes a seat next to Starlight.
I like seeing you do what you really love, writing and being involved in theater. You gave all that up in my time once you agreed to become the ruler of Europony.
Excuse me for saying, but you don't seem too happy about it either.
You've changed so much in my time because of it. I shouldn't be surprised, though. I can't imagine the stress he's under ruling over a kingdom like he does. He literally gave up everything he was passionate about, and it became more serious in general. Slowly, I'm starting to fall out of love with him.
Does he know you feel this way?
No, and to be honest, I don't know how to tell him. Aside from all that, me pretending to be royal isn't easy either. I'm expected to play a role in his reign that I'm just not capable of fulfilling. I have no idea how to play the political game, or how to plan a royal ball, or anything else that's expected of me. It's just a lot of pressure now, and we've lost that romantic spark over the past few months.
Well, I may not be my future self, but if he's anything like me, then he's going to want you to be honest with him.
Why? It's not like he's going to give up his reign of ruling over Europony for me. He's already made it abundantly clear that being the ruler of Europony is what he wants to do. I haven't told him how unhappy I've been, and it wouldn't be fair to him if I did.
It's better than you hiding your feelings and trying to be happy when you're not.
I haven't told him because I'm scared. I'm scared he won't give up his rule and in return break up with me. I know there's a lot of stress when it comes to ruling over a kingdom, but I don't like the pony he's become because of it. I don't know why I'm telling you all that.
Maybe it's because I'm your special stone pony where you come from. Starlight, you really need to have this conversation with him when you do return to your timeline. He deserves to know how you feel, and I'm certain that he'll listen to whatever concerns you have. I know I would.
The other part of it is, I miss my old life back in Ponyville with my friend. I felt like I was making a difference serving as Twilight's apprentice.
So, what's the deal with you and Shadow? There's clearly some history between the two of you.
There is, but I don't want to talk about it.
You really should, though, Starlight.
The past couple of days have been incredibly hard on me, to say the least. Being alone and around him again has brought back feelings I thought were dead. I really shouldn't be telling you. It's kind of a long, complicated story.
Well, you know I love a good story, and we have time, so please, tell me.
This is exactly the reason I fell in love with you. Before my will became too busy being royalty, he would always listen to my story. The one thing I never talked to him about was the baby I lost. Shadow was the father.
I see, and why haven't you?
It's too painful to talk about. I really never grieved over the baby I lost. To be honest, I don't think Shadow ever did either. To make a long story short, I lost Shadow to Twilight and my baby all in the same day. And rather than grieve and heal, I went into psychotic, vengeful rage. It was you, well, future you, who's helped save me from self-destruction. I guess being around Shadow again like this has brought back the feelings I had for him. But I know he doesn't feel the same for
me. Have you talked to him about this? I mean, your feelings, I mean.
Briefly. Our first night here, but he emotionally shut down the moment I tried to express my feelings to I wonder every day if he mourned our baby because he certainly didn't give a damn about me. I'm sorry, Will.
Starlight drops her plate of food on the floor and quickly exits the theater alone.
Present day timeline. Chaotic spaceship just outside Manhattan.
Well, it looks like we're spending the night here in Manhattan, and Manic locked up Chaotix's house, so we'll have to sleep in the X-Tornado tonight.
I'm sorry about that, Chris, but I had to do a thorough diagnostic evaluation of the ship, and I concur with both you and Charmy. The engines I could work around, but the damage to the landing gear is unrepairable. Unfortunately, Equestria doesn't make tires like this, nor do they have the parts to fix the damage to the landing gear itself. Chaotix won't be able to drive their spacecraft to Ponyville.
Well, do you think maybe Discord would want to help them out by using his magic to fix their ship, like he did with the X-Tornado after the battle with King Sombra?
I guess we could ask him, but I've never been on good terms with Discord, so he probably won't do me any favors. Especially if he knows what happened between me and Fluttershy.
Speaking of which, Tails, how are you feeling about everything that went down with Fluttershy? I don't know, Cosmo, or what you shared with her after you left Earth, but Fluttershy didn't deserve to have her heart broken.
I feel bad, Chris. I truly loved and still love Fluttershy. But what else am I supposed to do? I had no idea Cosmo was going to be resurrected from the seed Sonic gave me. You weren't there, Chris. Cosmo was my fiancé when she sacrificed herself to take out the Metarex.
I get that part of it, Tails, but hypothetically speaking, had Cosmo not come back, would you have forgiven Fluttershy and stayed with her?
I'm not sure, Chris. Fluttershy nearly killed me and said some of the most awful things to me. I just find it hard that an evil spell or whatever it was could make her forget everything wonderful that we did have prior to that. I know in the end it wasn't Fluttershy's fault for what happened, but I can't say I would have stayed with her even if Cosmo didn't return.
Fair enough. Well, Cosmo does seem like a really nice girl. You can tell she's completely in love with you. We have nothing but time tonight. You can tell me some of the stories you two went through together.
I guess if that's what you really want to do. I'll tell you all the fun stories, though, and maybe a few of the battles we went through? What did you want to grab for dinner? Whatever it is, it smells really good.
As long as I've been in Equestria, I've yet to try Latin Pony Cuisine. I want to see if a burrito here is anywhere near as good as it is in Station City back at home. I got you some tacos.
And to think we have to share the X-Tornado tonight.
What do you mean? I'm more worried about the flight back to Ponyville in the morning.
You know, Chris, I miss these days hanging out with you. Do you think we can do this more often?
I'd like that a lot, actually, Tails. I've always enjoyed fixing and working on projects with you. I'll help you clean up out here after we eat.
Sounds like a plan to me.
Tails and Chris enter the X-Tornado and begin eating their food. Meanwhile, Ponyville. Spike opens the front doors to Twilight's castle. Oh, hey, Manic. What are you doing here at this hour?
Sup, little dragon dude. Yeah, sorry for the late night visit, but I just got back into town today and finished up with rehearsals pretty late. I was hoping to see my sister Sonia before heading back to my hotel room for the night.
Oh yeah, she's still awake. Last time I saw Sonia, she was cleaning up on the second floor. Twilight has her on a jail sentence. Anyway, follow me, Manic. Manic follows Spike.
Yeah, I was hoping we could kind of change that, actually. Is Twilight still awake? This conversation includes her as well.
Twilight is in her library, I think.
Yep, Twilight is in her library, I think. I'll check to be sure, though. They reached the second floor. Sonya, you still up here? You have a visitor.
Yeah, I'll be down there in a minute.
She's down the hallway, probably cleaning out one of the guest bedrooms. You can go down and visit with her while I go and check to see if Twilight is up for company.
Cool. Thanks, Spike.
Anik walks down the hall and spots Sonya in a guest bedroom, sitting in a rocking chair.
Hey, nice to see you, Manic.
Likewise, sis. You doing okay?
Yeah, I guess. Essel Prison is definitely better than where I was a week ago.
Well, I'm hoping to change that for you, kid. How do you feel about moving to Manhattan with me? It would be a new beginning for both of us.
Anik, running from Pinky isn't going to solve anything.
Listen, Sonya, I've already heard this before. She's the best thing that's ever happened to me. Yada, yada, yada. That's what everyone keeps telling me. And yeah, I agree. At least, she was the best thing that's ever happened to me. I can't, Sonya. I can't erase the look Pinky has in her eyes as she was stabbing me. It was her, yet some pony completely different. I keep seeing it over and over and over again, to the point that I can't see any of the good we shared since. I can't be around her.
I've done far worse than Pinkie Pie has, and I wasn't under an evil spell like she was. And yet, you have no problem seeing me.
You never tried to kill me before, kid. Look, I really think if you moved to Manhattan with me, it'd be a great chance for you to find yourself, away from everything you've done. I mean, it's not like you have ever your magic anymore to cause havoc. If I can get Twilight to agree to this, and you're interested or not.
Of course I would be. But good luck with that. She's insistent that I serve the rest of my Tartarus sentence here. Holds up her leg, exposing her ankle. Or did you forget the magic she shot into my leg that prevents me from leaving the castle grounds?
Don't worry. I'll handle convincing Princess Twilight. Well, anyway, I better head downstairs and talk to Twilight before I do.
No, don't drink it. You put it on outside.
Well, good luck. And thanks for giving me yet another chance, Manic.
Don't mention it, sis. You know, I love you, kid. Do you want to come down with me and perhaps plead your case?
Sure, why not? I mean, it's better than cleaning bedrooms. Both head downstairs to talk to Twilight. Meanwhile, Twilight is fidgeting uneasily in her reading chair. I can't take this anymore, Spike! Oh, what? I can't take not knowing what's going on. I wish there were a way I could communicate with Starlight and Shadow. Uncertainty is unnerving.
There's nothing you can do about it, Twilight. So just try and be calm and have faith in Shadow. I'm sure nothing bad has happened to him or Starlight. Manic and Sonya appear in front of the entrance to Twilight's library. Oh, hey, Manic. Spike said there was something you needed to talk to me about, and I could really use a distraction at the moment, so please, come in. Sonya, did you finish cleaning all the guest bedrooms upstairs?
Well, no, but...
No buts. Now go back up and finish your chores.
Actually, Your Highness, I wanted Sonya to be here for this conversation since it pertains to her.
I have a feeling I know what you're about to ask me, and I can definitively say the answer is no. Sonya still has the rest of her Tartarus sentence to serve.
I told you she wasn't going to allow me to leave.
Of course not. Sonya, you have been nothing more than a menace to our society. And your track record of betraying our trust doesn't help after giving you multiple chances for change. You were sentenced to 3 years in Tartarus. Now, if you'd rather serve your sentence there than at my castle, I can easily have Princess Celestia send you back there.
No, I'll gladly stay here and serve out my sentence.
Come on, Twilight. Sonya doesn't have her powers anymore, so she's not a threat any longer. And besides, she'd be living in Manhattan with me. She deserves another chance, don't you think?
Absolutely out of the question, Manic. She's had at least 2 second chances at this point. And besides, the last time Sonya was in your care, she rebelled and released Nightshade from his statue.
Forget about it, Manic. She's right. I'm sorry for all the trouble I've caused, Your Highness. I'm willing to do my time and to make amends for what I've done. I'm serious this time about wanting to live a normal life. I think using this prison sentence is exactly what I need to turn my life around.
I'm glad to hear you say that, Sonya. Only I hope you truly mean it this time.
I'm sorry, Manic, but Sonya must serve out her sentence. Speaking of Manhattan, don't you think you owe it to Pinkie Pie to go over and at least talk things out with her before you go running off there?
Pinkie Pie and I are finished. I can't be around her, Twilight, so Manhattan seems like the perfect place for me to start over. I was hoping Sonya could do the same, which is why I asked.
Believe it or not, Manic, this is a new beginning for Sonya. While she's here, serving out her sentence, I plan on teaching her the values of friendship and how important they are to ensuring Equestria's safety.
Hey, Toad Sonic, you are more than welcome to visit Sonya anytime you wish. If you ever need to talk about what happened between you and Pinkie Pie, I'm here to listen.
Thanks, but I'll pass on the friendship advice, Your Highness. Right now, Pinkie and I can't be fixed. Well, anyway, I better get going, sis. I'm sorry I couldn't get you released, kid.
It's all right, Manic. Twilight is pretty hell-bent on making sure I serve out my sentence, and deservedly so. Better just make sure you come and visit me from time to time.
You know I will when I have the downtime. Will Sonya be able to attend the album release party tomorrow night?
Yes, of course. I honestly think it would be a great opportunity for her to start making amends with everyone. I'll be attending with Spike, so keep my eyes on her.
Awesome! Thanks, Twilight. Well then, I guess I'll see you tomorrow night then, guys. Adios!
Meanwhile, 7 years in the past, the city of Vancouver, the train station, 10:15 a.m. Aeon and past Sunset Shimmer exit the train.
My guess is that Will Atkinson is either at his hotel or at the theater. Do you think we should attempt to find him prior to his show this evening? It's going to be hard getting into the theater considering the show is already sold out.
No. Shadow is probably guarding Will. It would be best if we attack during the show tonight. As I stated prior, the show being sold out makes no difference to me. We'll use brute force to get into the show and give them a show they'll never forget. I'd rather use this downtime of peace for us, Sunset.
Really?
Yes, because you need to get more comfortable with me, my dear. You don't know me like my Sunset knew me, so this is a chance for us to get more acquainted.
Wow, I guess I really do matter to you. What did you have in mind?
Apparently, there's a uniquely historic museum here in Vancouver. I wouldn't mind going to see it if you're up for it.
I never really figured you for being much of an art guy.
I'm not, but I know you enjoy it. You told me about this museum when we were getting acquainted in my time, while we were in the human realm.
I see. Well, it's good to know that other versions of myself have an appreciation of art. Back when I was a filly, I often wrote poetry about my struggles in Princess Celestia's magic school.
You turned those poems into music, right? Past Sunset nods.
Mm-hmm.
Past Sunset nods.
It's how I dealt with the darkness that began to fill my mind. My mother played a large role in that, and of course my own jealousy of Twilight. When I felt most vulnerable, I would sing some of those lyrics to calm myself.
They continue walking.
I, too, know of great darkness. When I was a young hedgehog, my village was attacked by this creature. Well, demon is more like it. His name is Eclipse the Darkling, and he came for this crystal you see hanging around my neck. He slaughtered my entire village for it. Everyone died, including my father. Only myself and my dear friend Amber escaped. My father gave me this crystal and said it was my duty to protect it, and to one day use its powers to defeat Eclipse. And when that day came, Amber was slaughtered, and I barely escaped with my own life, opening a portal to a different timeline, the timeline in which I now consider my own.
I'm very sorry to hear that. What exactly does this crystal of yours do?
It has the power to absorb powers into it, and it also has the power to create portals to any time period or place in which you want to go to. The holder of this crystal is capable of using whatever powers the crystal itself has absorbed, hence why Eclipse wants it so badly.
But now you want to use its power to take over the multiverse.
Precisely. There will be universal peace in the cosmos thanks to me. Once I absorb Will's power, I will become the god of power. And once that happens, there will be no one alive that will be able to oppose my rule, dear.
All living beings in existence will obey or die, Sunset. It would be their choosing.
You do realize that the God of Power was defeated by a God who had even greater power, right?
I'm well aware of that, Sunset, but that God will never be allowed back into this realm. I will make sure of that when I destroy the Chaos Emeralds, along with that infernal Master Emerald. And how do you know of this story, Sunset? Princesses Celestia and Luna have been covering the truth of this up ever since your kind was banished to this world by the Echidnas.
We have our own legends and stories about how things went down. We were told both gods destroyed each other with their powers, and their spirits were left inside of magical trinkets of unknown origin.
Well, that's at least half true. Enerjack, the god of chaos as he's now known, his spirit lies within all the Chaos Emeralds and the Master Emerald itself. He must be summoned out by the guardian of the Master Emerald, and even once that's done, it takes a living sacrifice for him to return in a physical form. Now do you understand why it's important for me to obtain the Triad of Power into my crystal? I will destroy those cursed emeralds, making sure Enerjack can never return to any realm, and I will be left to reign supreme over all creation.
Meanwhile, Starlight and Shadow's hotel room.
I want to know right now what happened between you and Will last night, Starlight. Clearly, he said something that upset you.
I don't want to talk about it. It's not going to change anything, even if I did. The only thing it would change is my relationship with Will. Well, the Will of our time, of course.
I knew there was more to this than what you originally wanted me to know. What exactly is going on here, Starlight? What aren't you telling me?
Stop! I don't want to tell you because I already know where you stand. I need to let go and move on.
Let go of what, Starlight?
Of us, Shadow! My love for you and our baby that we lost!
You're still in love with me, Starlight?
Yes. I'm still in love with you, but we both know it doesn't matter to you. What hurts even more is the fact that you never mourned the baby we lost at Chrysalis's hooves. After you broke my heart, you ran straight to Twilight!
It's not true, we both know it. After Twilight broke Chrysalis's spell on me, I tried to work things out with you. You're the one who refused and threw me out of your life.
Well, what was I supposed to do, knowing it was Twilight's love that broke Chrysalis's spell on you when my love failed?
Look, Starlight, I'm sorry we ended the way we did. Even after the truth came out, I wanted to still be with you, but you threw it away.
I was in pain, Shadow! We lost our baby!
Yes, and instead of letting me in and mourning together, you allowed your jealousy of Twilight to take over you. I tried to be there for you after, but you were blinded by pain and shut me out. So of course I ran to Twilight, and she was there for me when I was mourning our child. You don't think I still mourn every day for the baby we lost?
I'm sorry for bringing this up now. It's just being here in this time along with you again has brought all of these unresolved feelings that I've had for you out. I know it's too late for us to reconcile, Shadow. In fact, there can never be one because in the end, it was your true feelings for Twilight that saved you from Chrysalis. At that point, I was second best, and had we stayed together, it would have been a lie. We have a job to do, Shadow. We need to stay focused on that because Equestria is counting on us to stop Aeon.
While I do agree Aeon needs to be the focus here, we need to finish this conversation and bury the past of us forever, Starlight. I'll be the one who starts by telling you we have no future together, Starlight. But if you were planning on ending things with Will on the notion of that, I suggest you find another reason to want to break up with him.
Thanks. Thanks for being so brutally honest, Shadow.
Starlight rushes into the bathroom and begins crying.
Starlight! I'm sorry, but I had to.
Go away, Shadow. Just leave me alone.
Fine. I'll leave you alone, but I had to be honest with you.
Message received, Shadow. Now please leave.
Ugh.
Shadow grunts, shaking his head as he exits the hotel room. Meanwhile...
Nightshade's Castle, the province of Europony. Present-day timeline.
Prince William is publicly addressing the citizens of Europony. Citizens of Europony, first off, I want to thank you all for welcoming me these past few months as your prince and sovereign ruler. Now, I know many of you may be wondering, why is Prince William addressing us from Nightshade's Castle? And the answer is quite simple. There is a major threat upon my life that puts the very balance of life in jeopardy for the entire planet. And as a precaution, I will be returning home to Ponyville temporarily. Do not fear, however. I will continue to run our prosperous kingdom from afar, and my uncle Nightshade will execute all of decrees directly to you all. In the past, my uncle has proven to be a great leader and has been highly respected by you all. I have the utmost confidence in him as he runs Europony in my stead. I promise that once this threat has been eliminated, I will return to rule over this great province. At this time, I would like to allow Nightshade to address you as well. Nightshade takes center stage as Prince William steps back from the edge of the balcony.
Greetings and salutations once again to all my fellow Europonians. I want to once again thank you all for your support and faith that you continuously show in my abilities to lead this prosperous province. I want to begin by stating that this arrangement is completely and mutually agreed on being temporary. I have new goals and aspirations in the province of Equestria that I would like to achieve, so my time here with you all in Europony is drawing to an end. I am, however, deeply honored that I could once again return home and lead this great province. I haven't been back to this castle in many, many days. Given the recent company we had here and the tragic events that took place, I no longer view this castle as my home. I know many of you have been worried of my well-being following the incidents with Dark Swirl and her sister Saletta, but I can assure you I am doing well. As I stated, I have found reasons to begin a new life in Equestria, and helping Prince William in his time of need is only a detour for me. And I am doing my part to help ensure the safety of not only Europony, but the entire planet itself. I will completely be ruling Europony under Prince William's edicts and am merely the executor of any decrees he may have. I want to finish by saying thank you once again for all your love and support that you have given me since my return. Europony will always be a special place in my heart. The ponies below begin to cheer loudly for Nightshade. Prince William gives Nightshade a subtle nod, thanking him for his service. Hunter walks up to stand next to Nightshade.
This is quite the reception for you, Senpai. Are you sure you've been able to give this all up again?
I've made up my mind already, Hunter. What I truly want resides in Equestria. My question for you, Hunter, is, are you sure you want to accompany me after this?
Well, there's nothing really keeping me grounded here in Europony now the fidget is gone. So yes, Nightshade, I would be honored to accompany you on your new life in Equestria. Let's just say, I have my own reasons for wanting to make Equestria my permanent home as well.
Excellent. It's good to know I'll have a loyal friend at my side. If you don't mind my asking, what is your reason for wanting to make Equestria your new home?
Much of the same reasoning as yours, Senpai. I feel like I have a purpose and a future there. And to be honest, pretty much everyone I know from my life on Mobius resides there. It'll be nice to attempt to live a peaceful life with them, and then their shadow.
Noble rat.
There's been so much tension over the years between Shadow and I. My creator, Dr. Eggman, is to blame for that. But I feel like we had a breakthrough when we were reunited at Twilight's Castle. I can sense that Shadow's heart has changed immensely since I last saw him. Call it an intuition, but I feel like he needs me somehow, and I would love nothing more than to attempt to bury the hatchet between us.
Aside from you, Hunter, the noble rat Shadow is the only other one of your kind I trust.
Well, I may have to intervene to help you in that regard, Senpai.
The guests begin to file into Town Hall for the DJ Pwn 3 Band album release party.
Nice dance moves, Pinky.
You're not too bad yourself, Sonic.
Well, Pinky seems to be in better spirits. How are you holding up, Fluttershy?
Not too good, actually. And honestly, I only came to support Pinky. She's really hoping to have a chance to talk to Manic to me. He's been avoiding her like a plague ever since.
Yeah, I'm sorry about you and Tails. Look at that sly splink of a fox over there with his fiance.
I don't really want to talk about that.
Twilight, Sonya, Spike, and Cream make their entrance into the party.
What the hell is she doing here?
Who?
Sonya!
Hey, sis. It's nice that you made it here tonight. Thanks for allowing her to come, Twilight.
Despite her being on castle arrest, I felt that it was acceptable for her to be here in support of Manic, and to perhaps make amends for what she's done.
Sonic embraces Sonya.
Thanks, Sonic. I'm really excited to see Manic perform. It's been years since I've last seen him on stage.
Yeah, and apparently he's singing a couple of songs tonight.
Wow, Manic actually sings now, huh? Now I really can't wait.
Well, I'll leave you two to catch up. Enjoy yourself tonight, Sonya. This is a big step in your reformation process. Come on, guys. Ooh, hors d'oeuvres. Yes. Oh, the baby is going to love it.
I think Twilight is the one who's going to need the chaperone tonight.
Ooh, looks like Sadie Bell's over there with Verity. Let's go hang out.
All right. They all branch off and do their own thing, leaving Sonic and Sonya to catch up.
Wow, sis. You look very nice tonight. Casual, yet classy. It's a good look for you, honestly.
Thank you, Sonic. Yeah, I have Mary to thank for this outfit. She made it for me when I first arrived here.
It brings me back to when we were kids. You were always the fancy, elegant one.
Yeah. Back to the times when I was happy and innocent. Sonic.
Yes, sis?
Do you think I'll ever truly be forgiven by everyone?
It's gonna take some time and effort on your part. Unfortunately for you, you've broken a lot of trust with everyone, and that's something that's not easily repaired.
Hey, Rainbow Dash! Wow, you're looking gorgeous tonight.
Thanks! You look amazing too, Sonya. It's pretty cool that Twilight allowed you to come. I know Manic definitely wanted you here.
I know he did. He practically went to war with Twilight over it. Twilight thinks this is a way for me to start making amends as well. Look, I know I don't deserve forgiveness or even a second chance, but...
Second chance? Sonya, this is like your fourth chance. And to me, you only allowed one chance to change.
Oh, come on, Dashy. I know loyalty is a big thing with you, but how many times has Discord been forgiven by you guys?
More than he deserved, but he's proven himself to have Equestria's best interest at heart. You, on the other hoof, haven't, Sonya. In fact, you've only given us reasons to not trust you.
I know I've told you this before, but I'm really gonna try this time. After spending time in Tartarus, I can honestly say I don't ever want to go back there again. And I legitimately want to rekindle my relationship with my brothers.
I so badly want to believe you, Sonya. Really, I do. But if you want to win our trust back, especially mine, then you're going to have to really start proving you're worthy of it and earn it, dude.
But how, though? I don't have my powers any longer to help protect Equestria.
You don't need your powers to prove yourself. Those powers of yours is what led you down the wrong path to begin with. You earn our trust, then learn everything you can about friendship from Twilight and start there.
Dash does have a point there, sis. If you're gonna learn how to build healthy relationships, Then who better than the Princess of Friendship to teach that to you?
Look, right now I can forgive you, Sonya, and allow you one last chance to change, because we are technically family, but it's going to take time for you to win back my trust completely. In the end, I would love to have a sisterly relationship with you. I guess only time will tell, though, huh?
Sonya smiles. That's fair enough for me. I'm sorry, Rainbow Dash. They hug.
Meanwhile...
Silver leading Blaze out to dance.
Silver, what are you doing? You know I don't like to dance in public.
What scares you about it? I'm no better of a dancer than you are. This is a chance for us to just have fun for once.
I suppose you're right, Silver. We have never danced before, and it does look like fun. So, how does one dance to a song that's this fast? I'd rather something slower and allows you to hold me.
I guess we can try what they're doing.
I'm not spinning on the top of my head.
Come on! I mean, we have powers and all. It can't be that hard, right?
Silver attempts to mimic some breakdancing. Tries to do the head spin and falls over, knocking Pinkie Pie down.
Ow! Sweet Celestia Silver, who taught you how to dance? Allow me, the amazing Pinkie Pie, to show you how it's freaking done, you bozo!
Pinkie Pie starts breakdancing and seemingly defies physics.
Oh, wow! Yeah, I can't do that.
Lame! The problem is, you don't have any rhythm to the music! I guess picture breakdancing like fighting! You can do all these really cool flippity kicks and punch combinations, and if you think about it, it kinda looks like breakdancing. Maybe try some of your fighting moves.
Over attempts.
Now that looks even more ridiculous.
Yeah, you're screwed! Oh well, I guess it doesn't hurt to just let loose and look like a fool. Don't mind if I move over here though and keep a really, really safe distance.
Gee, thanks, Pinky.
You're right, this is fun. I've never seen you act like this before, Silver. It's refreshing, actually.
Well, you and I haven't had too many moments in life where we could do something like this, if you think about it.
This is true. We're always too busy fighting or protecting Mobius to have fun. I do think we managed some fun moments despite all the chaos.
Silver and Blaze begin slow dancing.
Now, this is more like it.
I agree. Silver, do you remember some of the moments we shared in the past?
I do, actually. I remembered almost all of them. Mainly because each moment we had was another moment I fell in love with. I was always too shy or nervous to say anything in those days. I mean, you are a princess, and I was merely your sworn protector.
You're always more than a bodyguard to me, Silver. You're the most loyal friend, and we fought every battle side by side. The more we spent time together, the more we opened up to one another. You know, most princesses would hate the idea of having a guy protecting her at all time. But when we met, I immediately was attracted to you, Silver. You've already had the most sincere and honest eyes I've ever seen. So, do you have a favorite moment?
I don't know if I have a favorite moment with you. They were all pretty awesome and played a part in how I fell in love. But I do have the moment etched in my memory of when I was undoubtedly in love with you.
Oh. I wonder if ours is the same. Please, continue.
It was that one night we shared at your friend's birthday party. You were reminiscing on your childhood. I remember seeing your face light up with joy. You had the most amazing smile that I've ever seen while you were talking. I could listen to those stories forever. And I remember sitting there and thinking about how beautiful you looked, how happy you were. And that's when it hit me that I was in love with you. Even though I didn't say it, that was the moment in which I held your hand for the first time. You were so wrapped up in your story that you didn't even notice it at first. In my subtle, shy way, that was me telling you that I love you.
I didn't notice, and the reason I didn't react to it right away was because I knew it in that moment what you were trying to tell me. I felt it in that moment too, Silver. I guess we were both too damn shy to say anything. It was only a few years ago, but it seems like an eternity has passed.
We got pretty sidetracked soon after that, and then I had to come to this timeline to try to help Sonic fight the Metarex. I wish I would have told you before I left. I looked back at my time here, and I can't believe I've fallen for Rarity. You two are such polar opposites. What was I thinking?
Do you think you would have married her if I hadn't showed up when I did?
I'm not sure, Blaze. Rarity and I were already broken up when you arrived, and to be honest, I'm not sure we would have been able to work out our differences. Rarity has always been harsh with her words and actions without thinking of the consequences that may harbor. I tried to give her a second chance, but she wasn't having it.
I see. So what you're saying is that...
I'm pretty sure Rarity and I were done. You showing up when you did only made it easier on me. I've always had feelings for you, Blaze. I've just never had the courage to tell you sooner.
Blaze gives Silver a smile before embracing him. They continue dancing. The addict's having fun hanging out and scoping out the room.
Man, this is a really cool party. Hey, guys?
Yeah, you said it, kid. These ponies know how to party.
How about you, Espio?
Yeah, I guess I'm enjoying myself.
You seem distracted or thinking about something.
I'm just looking at all our friends. They all seem happy now and enjoying life with their partners. It's rather comforting, actually.
I couldn't agree more, Espio! We've all been through a lot this past year following the destruction of Mobius, that it is good to see everyone happy. I'm pretty pumped to see Manic perform again. It amazes me that he's Sonic's twin brother, and I never knew until we arrived here.
Yes, and he has a sister we never knew about as well. Vector, do you think we're all going to be okay here?
I think we will be. I know our friends have had their fair share of battles on this planet since arriving here, but seeing how they've bonded and banded together gives me hope for us. Looking at them, it makes me reevaluate what's been missing in my own life.
Oh no! Don't tell me you're gonna get sappy on us again, boss!
I'm getting older, Charmy. I mean, sure, I've loved the life I've lived so far, having all these adventures with you guys, but there's always been something missing for me. I don't know, maybe it's never gonna happen for me. You and Cream seem to hit it off, though.
What? Well, what do you mean by that?
Aw, oh, come on, kid! Espio and I saw how you reacted to seeing Cream again. Admit it, Charmy, you have a crush on her.
I do not. And besides, she's an angel.
So?
It would never work between us. She's a divine being, and has major responsibilities that come with that title. I'm not even sure she's allowed to experience love.
Well, you'll never know unless you try, kid.
Charmy looks at Espio. I mean, I'm no expert in the field. Vector is correct, Charmy. You've clearly had feelings for Cream for a while now, so why not tell her about it? Charmy looks over in Cream's direction. Cream catches Charmy looking at her. She smiles and gives him a wave.
Crap! She saw me looking at her!
Yes, and she smiled and waved at you, Charmy.
Should I go over there?
Yeah, you dummy!
Aw, man! Is my antenna straight? Am I looking as cute as usual?
You look and are your normal, charming self, Charmy.
Yeah, kid! Now go!
Alright. Here I go.
Charmy walks over to Cream.
Hi, Charmy. Are you having a good time?
Yeah. And how about you?
Yeah, I am too. I can't wait to see Mr. Manic perform again. I saw him perform last year. He's really cracked it up.
Choo-choo.
You look very pretty tonight, Cream. I mean, you're pretty all the time. Would you maybe want to dance with me?
Cream grabs Charmy and brings him out to the dance floor.
Seriously? I wasn't sure what you were gonna say. You are an angel now, too, so...
I am, but that's something that I get into a dancing friend!
Friend! Right.
Fluttershy is sitting alone at a table. Tails walks over to her and sits down.
Hey, Fluttershy. Oh, hi, Tails. Where's your girlfriend? She's talking with Sonic right now, and I couldn't help but see you sitting over here by yourself. There's something I really need to tell you. Save your breath and your pity, Tails. I'm fine. I never meant to hurt you, Fluttershy, and I know deep down you never meant to hurt me, but you don't have to explain anything to me. You were never truly mine, were you? You would have left me for her no matter what. Admit it!
Yes. I would have left you for Cosmo regardless. I wish I could make this make sense for you without hurting you.
There is no way, Tails. You meant everything. Were my everything, my entire world. After everything we went through together. In the end, I mean nothing to you.
That's not true. I did fall in love with you, but I never expected her to come back. I'm truly sorry for the pain I caused you, Fluttershy.
Save it! I don't need your apology. All I want is for you to leave me alone. Please.
Vector notices.
Hey, I'll be back in a few minutes, SBO. Where are you going? You're going to miss Manic's performance.
No, I won't. I'll be back in a few minutes. Vector quickly chases after Fluttershy. Hey, wait a second. Fluttershy, right?
Forgive me, but I just want to be left alone right now.
I've never seen Tails make anyone cry and storm out like that before. I figured I'd at least come out and try to check on you.
Thanks. What was your name again?
Hector. I know we only met briefly, but is everything all right? Again, I've never seen Tails hurt anyone like that before.
I'll be fine.
Fluttershy flies off, leaving Vector behind. Vector walks back into the party.
What was that all about?
Nothing! I saw that Tails hurt Fluttershy's feelings, so I thought that I'd at least go out and check on her.
And judging by how fast you came back inside, I'd say she told you to get lost.
Ha ha! No, she basically got lost on her own. She flew off.
We barely know her name. What were you planning on accomplishing?
I don't know, SBO. She's kind of cute, and I was hoping to get her to stay and have a good time with us, you know.
Huh. So we're back to Vector's love arc, are we?
Yeah, that arc never seems to end, huh?
Oh my goodness! Possible it's been forever!
Oh crap, what is she doing here? Oh, hey, Pinkie Pie. Long time since I've seen you at a party.
Hey-ya! I know, right? So, what are you doing here?
Oh, you know, supporting my girl DJ Pond 3. You know?
Oh, right! You're part of her fan club or something like that, right?
Well, we're not official or anything like that, but I guess we're considered honorary groupies. What are you doing here?
I was invited by... Well... I guess my now ex-boyfriend Manic, but I'm hoping we're gonna work things out today. Manic is the drummer for the band.
Yeah, I'm aware of that. I was here last summer for their concert when they opened for Aura. You know what? I need to run to the mayor's room.
Pacific Glow rushes off to the bathroom.
Meanwhile, 7 years in the past, Vancouver's Art Theater.
Kaboom!
Oh! Aeon!
Starlight, Twilight, go and get Will as far away from this theater as you can. I'll stop Aeon by myself.
Right, let's go, Twilight.
Be careful, Shadow.
I'll be fine. I'm sure with my new powers, I should be able to take him down. We'll meet up at our hotel, Starlight, once Aeon is defeated.
Shadow flies down to face Aeon. He lands up the aisleway about 25 feet apart.
Killing you was never part of my plan, Shadow. In fact, I would love to have you serve as my right hand. You kill me? Don't make me laugh. You felt my power against Darkswirl, and that's why you tucked tail and attempted to come back to the past to absorb Will Atkinson's power. You know damn well you're no match for me. I wouldn't go getting ahead of yourself, Shadow. I've yet to test out my new powers. Oh, you mean your stolen powers? Oh, you should talk, Shadow. We both know the powers you currently possess aren't your own either. Maybe I should be calling you Princess Shadow, since it is their powers that you borrowed. You may be right about my powers being borrowed, but it's the magic of friendship that powers me now. And with that, I've become indestructible!
Miss me.
Damn it! Damn it! Let go of me, Aeon!
Shadow attempted a punch, but Aeon grabs Shadow by the wrist and holds him up off the ground.
Haven't you realized yet that this isn't going to be as easy as you thought? Shut the hell up!
I tried to help you, Shadow. Oh well, have it your way. Aeon punches Shadow in the abdomen with his blaster. Aeon still holding Shadow off the ground by his wrist.
And if you think Twilight and Starlight are going to have it any easier, let's just say I have a surprise waiting on them.
Boom! Aeon fires an energy blast through his blaster. The blast sends Shadow through the walls of the theater and out to the street.
Damn it!
Aeon climbs through the hole in the wall and stands outside looking down on Shadow, who begins to stand back up.
I guess the magic of friendship saved your ass on that exchange, Shadow. If you were Sonic, you'd have a hole the size of a dinner plate through your midsection. I really don't want to kill you, Shadow. So this is the last chance I'm offering you for you to join me at my side. Damn it! Never, Aeon! I came here to stop you. Dead or alive, it really would be a shame if you forced me to kill you.
Aeon teleported behind Shadow and kicked him in the side of the head, sending Shadow crashing through a restaurant. Boom! Aeon unleashes a barrage of fireballs from his hand while also firing blasts from his cannon. The building and surrounding area that Shadow is laying in explode. Meanwhile, back inside the theater.
What the hay is going on out there? I've never felt power like this before. It's frightening.
So that guy Shadow was fighting is the guy who's trying to steal my powers?
Yeah, that's Aeon.
Sunset Shimmer is blocking the back exit of the theater.
Well. It's been a while, Twilight. Glad to see you've made a full recovery from our last encounter. You look petrified to see me, Twilight. I can't say that I blame you. Although, it must be embarrassing for you being Princess Celestia's apprentice, knowing you're inferior to me. I'll tell you what, Twilight. Surrender now and allow me to take Mr. Atkinson for Aeon, and I won't hurt a purple, straggly strand of hair in your mane.
You know I won't surrender!
And here I am, turning over a new leaf by at least offering you a way out this time! Oh well, don't say that I never changed!
Starlight steps in front of Twilight.
Stand down, Sunset!
What are you even doing here, Starlight? I thought you traveled off to Mobius to meet Shadow. Guess you didn't have to travel far considering he's here. No, betraying your bestie for Twilight is a serious mistake.
Sunset fires an energy blast from her unicorn horn. Starlight quickly puts up a force field with her magic, protecting Twilight and Will from the blast.
Okay, Starlight, you officially made your choice.
Listen to her, Sunset. Aeon can't be trusted.
Like I would ever listen to you, Twilight. Aeon offered me a place at his side ruling over the entire universe. A life full of luxury and power. Exactly everything I ever wanted. And you expected me to turn that down?
I've had enough of this!
Will fires an enormous blast from his unicorn horn. The blast hits Sunset Shimmer and sends her flying through the wall of the theater.
Twilight, take Will and escape from the main theater entrance. I'll handle Sunset and try to talk some sense into—
Surprise!
Sunset teleported next to Starlight and clobbers her with a punch, knocking Starlight unconscious.
Guess it's just the three of us now, Twilight. You're a pretty powerful pony, Will. I now understand why Aeon wants to absorb your power so badly. You really should have surrendered when I gave you the chance, Twilight. But I'm glad you didn't, because I'll now have the pleasure of looking into your eyes as I watch death take you.
Twilight, go now! It's me she wants! You don't deserve to die protecting me! Besides, her friend needs me to be alive to absorb my powers, so I'm not gonna die in this fight with her.
But Will, her powers are the worst Equestria has ever seen.
I may not be adept at using my powers, but if the legend about my cutie mark is true, then I have divine power flowing through me. She won't stand a chance.
You're the one who doesn't stand a chance, Will. I already know I can't beat Twilight without this transformation. So I may as well go all out right from the start.
Oh no! She's transforming into Daydream Shimmer! We won't be able to beat her in that form! I have yet to test the limits of my so-called hidden powers. I think it's time to see what kind of powers I truly possess. Let me handle this, Twilight. If they want me, they aren't going to get me without a fight!
But Will, you've never been properly trained. Outside of normal magic, have you ever experimented with your true powers?
Very sporadically, and nothing formal. Up until now, I haven't had a reason to do so. I don't know what it is, but I feel this confidence coming over me that I'm going to take her down.
Now this is a moment of deja vu that brings back a fond memory, Twilight. That look of immense fear in your eyes. Princess Celestia had that same look, too.
Meanwhile, back in the present timeline, Manic has arrived at the album release party and is taking pictures with Sonic and Sonya.
Thanks for taking a few pictures of me, guys. It means the world to me that we're all here together.
I'm just grateful Twilight allowed me to attend. I'm so excited to see you on that stage again. I'm gonna totally rock out.
Just a word of warning, Manic. Pinkie Pie decided to come, and she's hoping to talk to you.
Yeah, I see her. I'm surprised her pinky senses didn't alert her that I'm here right now. With all that craziness that's been going on recently, I completely forgot to take her off the guest list.
Pinkie Pie looks over and spots Manic.
You spoke too soon, bro. Here she comes.
Pinkie Pie walks over to greet Manic.
Hey, Manny Kids! You look awesome for tonight!
Thanks, Pinkie Pie. Thanks for coming out and supporting the band.
You know I'm here for you, silly!
Yeah, I know you are.
Come on, Sonya. Let's give Manic and Pinkie Pie some time alone.
Good luck, you two, and work things out, will you?
Shut up.
Look, Manny, I know you've been avoiding me since the incident, but do you think we could talk at my place tonight after the party?
Pinky, I really don't have anything to say to you. I don't feel comfortable being alone with you at all right now.
But you know it wasn't me who stabbed you! I was under evil magic!
Look, I've already heard this before, Pinky. I can't just pretend like you stabbing me didn't happen. Sadly, it's all I see every time I either see or think about you.
I don't understand.
What's not to understand, Double P? You stabbed me twice! If you truly loved me, shouldn't I have stopped you?
I don't know! I'm not a pony capable of magic. I'm a simple earth pony. You forgave Sonic, and he's the reason we fell under Dark Souls' control to begin with.
Yeah, but according to him, he told you not to attack me, and you did anyway. If I were your kid, I'd leave this party right now because you aren't going to like what you see tonight.
But Manic...
Leave me alone, Pinky! Just go home and save yourself some more heartache. I gotta go. We're getting ready to take the stage.
Pinky is left heartbroken as Manic storms off to meet up with the rest of the band.
Well, that didn't end very well, did it?
No, it didn't. I hope Manic comes to his senses and forgives her. She really is the best thing to ever happen to him.
Meanwhile, 7 years in the past, Van Hoover. Chaos Spear!
Shadow sends a barrage of chaos spears that hit Aeon dead on and send him into the ground. Shadow rushes into the smoke and kicks Aeon back into the air. Shadow follows him up and buries his foot into Aeon's abdomen. Aeon coughs up blood and gets smashed into the ground again. Aeon stands up.
Give it up, Aeon! You're no match for me, and I'm in base form!
You're forgetting one small detail, Shadow.
And what's that?
Aeon uses his magic crystal to heal himself.
Oh, damn it! I forgot about that stupid crystal of yours! Now I'm going to make it a point to destroy every piece of that relic before this battle is over!
And what makes you think you'll be successful when I haven't shown my true powers yet?
What the hell do you mean by that?
I'll show you, my friend. It's time. I turn the tables and show you the power of 2/3 of the God of Power.
Aeon's crystal begins to glow violently as he begins to transform.
Oh, what the hell? How could I have forgotten about this? His power. God damn it! I'm not even sure what the depths of my new powers are, or its limitations.
Judging by the look on your face, Shadow, I'd say my new form is rather impressive. That or perhaps it's my power that frightens you. Not to worry, Shadow. Go ahead and transform into your princess form. I want a suitable test run for my new divine powers.
Think you're going to make a sport out of me, do you, Aeon? Well, I guess this is a test run for both of us! You're going to regret this, Aeon! Are you satisfied?
Beyond satisfied, Shadow. This should be a great test for both of us, wouldn't you agree?
I would say enjoy this power while you have it, Aeon, because it'll be the first and last time you get to experience it!
Enough talk.
For once, we agree!
Aeon powers up and rushes Shadow. Shadow disappears and reappears behind Aeon.
Boom, boom, boom!
Aeon is sent through multiple buildings. Aeon hits the ground with a thunderous boom. Aeon explodes with rage and comes flying out of the rubble. He takes a swing at Shadow. Shadow dodges and delivers a knee to Aeon's abdomen. Aeon spits up blood. Shadow sends Aeon crashing into the ground with the blow to the back of the head.
Meanwhile, back inside the theater, Twilight is checking on Starlight.
Come on, Starlight, wake up! We need your help!
Starlight begins to regain consciousness.
She's fighting Will. He's not going to last much longer, but I have an idea that will require your powers.
How so? I'm not powerful enough to stop the one she's in this form.
You can use your powers to open a portal to another dimension. Somehow, some way, either myself or Will can use our powers to blast her into the portal. Once she's inside, we'll seal her away forever. I don't know! Any place but here!
I need to send her somewhere! I can't just open a portal with no destination!
We'll figure it out later! Right now, we need to help Will!
Past Twilight and Starlight rush outside the theater. They spot Will fighting with Daydream Shimmer.
I'm surprised you've been able to keep up with me! For some pony who's as untrained in Alicorn magic, you sure are putting up a great fight!
Don't act so surprised! You forget it's not just Alicorn magic I'm gifting with! It's divine magic!
Yawn.
Here goes nothing!
Will effortlessly cancels the blast out with his own blast.
You really thought you were gonna get me?
Daydream Shimmer appears behind Will and punches him in the face, sending him bouncing across the streets of Vancouver.
Will!
Stay back, Starlight! This is my fight!
Sunset, please stop this! You don't know anything about this Aeon guy! How could you trust him so quickly?
He's told me enough, and I believe every word he said.
Yeah, but you just got released from Tartarus! Do you really want to wind up back there if you fail?
No, because Aeon and I won't fail!
Daydream Shimmer powers up and fires a massive energy blast at Twilight and Starlight.
I'm not powerful enough to stop that!
Will rushes in flight and takes the blast head-on for Starlight and Twilight. The force of the blast knocks Will, Starlight, and Twilight unconscious. Meanwhile, back where Shadow and Aeon are fighting, Shadow and Aeon are exchanging punches and kicks in midair. Each impact causes a loud boom. Shadow gains the upper hand by roundhouse kicking Aeon across the sky.
I must admit, Shadow, I've underestimated your power in this new form of yours. I'm quite surprised. It's been able to match my power. Yes, and to think I don't even have the Chaos Emeralds with me for additional power. Luckily for you, I guess. Nice try, Aeon. You're gonna have to do better than that if you're going to defeat me. Don't get ahead of yourself, Shadow. Chaos Blast!
Kaboom!
I must admit, Aeon, I'm impressed. That last attack of mine reduced Darkswirl to nothing more than a pile of ashes. Well, I've got news for you, Shadow. I'm not Darkswirl. Ah! Do better than that, Shadow.
At this point, Daydream Shimmer begins to sneak up on Shadow. Aeon spots her.
That a girl, is that Sunset? What a different form that is. I'm not used to seeing her in that form. You know, you really should pay more attention to your opponent, Aeon! Now, it's time to finish you! Chaos Breath!
What?
Ooh. As powerful as you are, Shadow, you can still be defeated when you let your guard down. Isn't that right, my dear Sunset?
What? Sunset?
Daydream Shimmer slowly pulls her horn out of Shadow.
I failed.
I didn't intend for it to be like this, Shadow. I truly considered you a friend and gave you the chance of joining me. It's a shame, really, that despite your immense power, you were defeated by a simple unicorn horn. It just goes to show that even the most powerful can be slain when their guard is down. Farewell, Shadow. I have a triad of power to complete. You have my word I shall not harm Twilight, unless she gives me a reason to do so.
Aeon, please heal me.
No, Shadow. I gave you your one and only chance. Healing you now is too big of a risk, I'm afraid. I've had enough. Take me to Willackinson Sunset. It's time I complete the Triad of Power and claim my place as the God of Power. I will always respect you. Farewell, Shadow.
Aeon and Sunset fly off towards Willackinson.
Damn it! He's right. I didn't even sense her coming. Beaten by Sunsets. Sorry. I